Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creative Process. Today we'll be creating this cool typography text effect in Illustrator. To design this, we'll first write out the word using the pen tool. Then we'll look at how to apply gradient color that follows along the stroke path. And lastly, add a drop shadow under the overlapping areas. So let's begin with the tutorial. Here is the design which we have created earlier. Let's create the design on a new artboard. Select the pen tool using the keyboard shortcut B. We'll write the word finale. So click and drag to get the shape F. We'll write all the alphabets in a single stroke. Draw E followed by double N. Make sure that there is no sharp corners throughout the design. All the corners has to be smooth and curved. After this, we'll do the refinement. So select direct selection tool and start tweaking the anchor points. Adjust the position and direction using the handles. Tweak each and every anchor points until you get a smooth and clean design. Add a new anchor point if necessary to get a proper refinement. Next, we'll do some adjustments with the shear angle. So right click and go to transform and select shear. This will open the shear option panel. Here we'll set the axis angle to 112 degree and the shear angle to 354 degree and click OK. Next, we'll do some adjustments with the slice. So go to object, envelope distort, make with mesh. Here, set the row and columns one by one. This will give us four anchor points, which we can adjust using the direct selection tool. Now narrow down the distance between two right side anchor points and adjust the handles to get a little angular displacement. Now go to object and expand the design. Then right click and ungroup it. This way we can again select the stroke and do the adjustments using the direct selection tool. We'll go to each and every anchor points to do the final refinement. Once done, the next step is to apply a proper gradient color. So select a design, then go to stroke and choose a gradient color. We'll be applying this four color on our gradient. So select the first shape, then click on the fill color and copy the color code. Now select a design and choose stroke color. Then open gradient panel, double click on the first slider and paste the color code. In the same way, we'll copy the color code for the second shape and under the stroke gradient color, double click on the second slider to paste the color code. You'll see the changes on our typography text. In the same way, we'll copy the other two color codes and paste it under stroke gradient color sliders. Now, the next thing we're gonna do is to apply the gradient color in such a way that it follows the stroke path. Let me show you with an example. If we draw out a rough stroke, you can see that the gradient color goes from left to right. It doesn't follow the stroke. So to make it follow the stroke, we'll click on this icon to apply gradient along stroke. Now you can see the gradient start from this point, follows the whole path and finish it at the last point. It will not be disturbed even if you modify the shape. We can also apply gradient across strokes using this icon. Now let's apply the same effect to our main design. Select the word and click on this icon under gradient panel. Now we'll adjust the sliders to give a proper color transition throughout the stroke path. Next, we'll add a drop shadow under the overlapping areas. So select a design and click and drag with the Alt pressed to create a duplicate. Now choose stroke option and fill it up with a single color. Now go to object, path, outline stroke. This will change the stroke to fill object. Next, we'll use pen tool and draw out outlines where the strokes are overlapping on our main design. So click and fill up the empty path. Then add one more stroke to gather shadow area. Draw out on the outline over here. Press P to break the point. Then draw out on the stroke for the shadow region. In the same way, we'll try to follow along the incomplete path by adding outline. and draw out a stroke by leaving certain area on every single intersection. Next, select everything, including the fill object, and using the Shape Builder tool, click on all the subdivisions to extract out the shadow area. Now, using the selection tool, select all, then deselect the fill object. Then deselect all the subdivisions and click delete. This will delete all the extra strokes. Now to select all the subdivision shapes, select all and deselect the fill object. Now drag and place it over the main design. Zoom in to do the proper placement. Next, we'll apply gradient color to all the shapes. So select all the shapes and click on the gradient icon. Then under gradient panel, choose white and black. Now double click on the first slider and change the color to black. Then reduce the opacity to 0. Now go to transparency and change the blend mode to overlay and set the overall opacity to around 71%. Now using the gradient tool, set a direction of each of the gradient color. The darker color should be toward the stroke. This will make it look like there is a drop shadow under the overlapping areas. Next, we'll adjust the opacity of each of the shapes. We'll set the opacity around 98% for the first few shapes, 43% for the end shapes, and around 52% for the middle region. Next, we'll type out the text with the font Existence Light. Choose purple color from the color picker and place it on the right side of our design. Next, we'll create a blending design for our background. So draw out two curves, then using the blend tool, click on the first, then on the second stroke. Then double click on the blend tool icon to open the blend option panel. Here set the specified steps to 60 and click OK. Let's do little modification and slight adjustments with the gradient color. We'll apply white and black gradient, but in opposite direction. Next, select our design and drag and drop it to our new Photoshop document. Scale up the size and place it in the center. Now drag in our background design and rotate it to an angle. Scale up the size and place it below. Reduce the opacity to 19% and add a new hue and saturation adjustment layer. Click on this icon to apply only to the selected layer. Give a greenish color tone. Now select our design layer and add a new hue and saturation adjustment layer. Click on this icon. And here we can do all the adjustments with different color tones. You can choose any gradient color you like. Finally, we have completed designing a typographic text effect. During the process, we have understood how to apply gradient color that follows along the stroke and adding a nice drop shadow under the overlapping areas. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.